Not bad. I was the third person up this morning, and now the lifts are shut down, so I should be able to have plenty of space on these runs. Let's make some turns and then chat. Such awful views.
Yeah.
And you need me off.
Yeah.
Dang, I should have started shooting earlier. All right, skipping ahead a couple days here, because, the other day, ski patrol, they got to make sure everyone's off the mountain. So, had to exit, and then by the time I was off the gondola, it was just too dark to finish taping. But I really hope that you and your families and everyone is doing all right during these weird times. I kind of had a great summer in weird ways, but, yeah, I also didn't want to think about social media at all. I kind of feel like I've never even been good at social media. Just when I'm having fun snowboarding and have an insight of something that I want to teach or some random tip, then it just, the videos can flow out. So hopefully I can get into that zone quicker than later, sooner than later. But preseason, that's just not the time for me to be making videos. The runs can just be way too crowded and congested, and it can be very dangerous for me to be doing that type of taping, especially if I'm working with someone else who is taping me. So it's just not my jam until enough of the resort is open, because like right now, all the people who are usually ride the top of the mountain and the horseshoe bowl and whatnot, they're on the same run. You got beginners on the same run. You got all the park kids. There's not park open yet. So you got all the them on the run. And the runs can just be sheer chaos at times and extremely dangerous, with some people just bombing straight down, others like me making big turns, other people doing whatever. A lot of people just jumping and hucking off everything. For me, preseason, I'm never fully feeling it right away. I never leave the next season where I finished last season. So last season, before shut down, I was actually working on switch stance heel side layout carves. So I had some new combos that I've never done or never had filmed yet. But once the season ended, I'm not there yet. So it'll just take a lot of turns and a lot of focused practice on my part, and I'll be back to being better than ever very soon. So I hope you stay tuned. I got a couple of videos that I'll be able to release without having to shoot. I shot one more ABCs of snowboarding, so that'll come up soon. So I hope you are able to get out on the slope soon, enjoy some awful views like that, because wow, the views have been amazing. It's been like spring conditions here lately. We actually got quite a lack of snow, but the weather's been beautiful for it. But hopefully we can get everything open sooner than later. And I just hope you guys stay safe and just find your own level of control on those first days of preseason, because it can be chaotic and some people are going so fast. You know, that's actually a good skier there, but it can be just the most dangerous time of the year, I feel, every year, the preseason. So I always want to have a full, long season. The worst time of my life has always been whenever I've gotten hurt. Years ago, I hurt my ankle once, couldn't snowboard for weeks. And I remember when I finally got out here and enjoyed the awful views, I started crying because I was so happy to be back on my board. So I just want a long season and not to deal with any chaoticness of preseason and potentially getting hurt. So definitely bring out extra mask on the mountain, so on those cold days when you're breathing through it and it starts to get icy, that it'll be good to go. I'll also put a link to my favorite balaclava on Amazon in the description, so check that out. And you get a two-pack, but again, I don't, it's for the lift lines and stuff. It's probably not, doesn't cut it for, you know, for actual virus protection. So, and the last thing I'll mention is Donick Snowboards has their Black Friday special going on right now. I think it's $100 off any boards. They also have quite a few of my custom snowboards, which are spec'd out to be more of the gentle than mine, of course. So just like the typical specs that we generally recommend for people who are getting into carving. So a bit wider, bit larger side cut radius, and they got a couple different flexes and stuff. Link in the description for that, so check that out if you are interested in a custom Donick snowboards, whether it be the graphics, whether it be the side cut radius, length, all that. They can do it all for you, so definitely check that out. And thank you all for watching. Happy shredding and kapla. And here's the rest of the footage from Friday. get the adrenaline flowing?